Hello everybody, welcome to the world of programming in C. This video series is basically meant for the beginners who want to learn programming in C from the scratch. So let us begin from the very first lecture of the series, that is Introduction to C. In this video, we shall have overview about various programming languages, their classifications, and important features of various groups of C programming languages. Then characteristic of C language, how to run a C program on a computer, and various merits and demerits of programming in C. So basically programming languages are divided into the two main groups. First group is high level computer languages. Second is low level or machine level computer programming languages. There is also third group which contains the characteristics of both high level as well as low level languages. This is known as mid level language. C language is a peculiar example of mid level programming language as it contains the salient features of both high level language as well as low level or machine language. So high level language, these are basically English like languages. Their commands are similar to the common English words used in our daily life. Their syntax is very easy and they are designed to simplify the work of a computer programmer. The instructions used in high level language are very simple, very near to the English sentences, so that a computer programmer can easily learn them, memorize them, recall them while developing a program in a high level language. But the problem with high level language programs is that computer does not understand the program written in a high level language. Computer understand only the programs written in low level languages. So before executing the programs written in high level languages, these programs need to be converted to low level language so that they can be understood by the computer and the CPU can execute these programs. So let us have a look at a program written in, which is basically an example of a high level language program. So in this program you can see that various words like include, main, print, these are the commands which are quite similar to the words used in our daily life. Although at this point we have no idea about what a C program is, but still we can easily understand what is written over there. Suppose include. Include word is used to include something into the other. So here include command or the word is used to include stdio, standard input output file, into this program. Similarly, main word shows that our main program starts from this point. And print command is used to display this message on the screen. So from this example we can interpret that high level language uses commands which are quite similar to the words and the sentences used in the common language. Hence, a programmer can easily learn them, recall them while developing a program. So, it simplifies the work of a programmer. Low-level languages. These type of languages are basically designed for the computers. CPU understand these languages and CPU can directly execute these programs. So it contains instructions which are recognized by the computer or the CPU. Low level code or the instructions are such that they are not easily readable by the human beings. These are normally in the form of binary. And these low-level languages are subdivided into two groups, that is assembly language and मशीन लैंग्वेज। मशीन लैंग्वेज इज़ अ प्योर बाइनरी लैंग्वेज, इट कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ जीरोज एंड वंस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी द कोड्स रिटन ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द स्क्रीन, दीज आर द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ जीरोज एंड वंस ओनली। फॉर एग्जाम्पल कंसनट्रेट ऑन द फर्स्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन विच इज 0011 एंड सीरीज ऑफ जीरोज, दिस स्टैंड्स फॉर रीड एन टू एक्यूमुलेटर। सिमिलरली सेकेंड ग्रुप स्टैंड्स फॉर जम्प टू डन इफ एन इज लेस देन जीरो, एंड थर्ड सब ग्रुप स्टैंड्स फॉर एड इंस्ट्रक्शन, फोर्थ स्टैंड्स फॉर स्टोर इंस्ट्रक्शन एंड सो ऑन। So these are the codes which are written in zeros and ones, and computer understands which combination of zero and one stands for which instruction. So it reads that particular binary code and execute the corresponding instruction. Normal computer programmer cannot memorize these codes and cannot write program directly in a binary language. So to overcome this problem, we have designed assembly language programs in which in place of binary codes, we use three or four letter combinations. For example, CMP for compare, JL for jump if low, again CMP for compare, JG jump if greater, SUB for subtract, RET for return, and so on. These type of three letter words are known as mnemonics, and these represent binary codes basically in the background. So as we cannot memorize the binary codes of machine level languages, we replace those codes with this English like three or four letter combination words which are known as mnemonics and are followed by operands, source and destination. So these are comparatively easier to understand, but these are still far away from the high level language. So even assembly language comes under the low level language group, and it needs to be converted into the binary language or the machine level language before execution. High level versus low level language. Now let us have merit and demerit of high level and low level language. First parameter is understanding. High level language is better understood by human beings, and low level language is understood by computers. Rather, computer understands only the binary language, and speed and size are both interconnected. In high level language, there is a lot of overhead involved. For example, previous example, we have used include standard io.h in our program. So we use lot of overhead commands or unwanted functions in our high level language program, which makes the program bulky and relatively slower to run. Low level language have no such disadvantage. Program returns in low level language are smaller and lightweight and run much faster as compared to high level language programs. And program development time. As high level language is better understood and easy to recall and reproduce while developing, so developing a program in high level language platform is much faster and easy. But developing a program in low level language is time consuming and difficult. Last point is portability. Portability means when we can develop our C program on one system and can run it on another system. That is, we can move our program from one system to another is known as portability. High level languages are normally platform free. They can run on various platforms and are high in portability. But program written in low level language are hardware specific. Programs written for one particular processor cannot be run on another type of processor. So So the portability of low level languages is very low. Now comes to C, the mid level language. C program is considered a middle level language because it contains the salient features of both low level as well as high level language. And from the high level language, it contains the feature of faster development, ease of understanding because its syntax is like normal English like language. And it contains the merits of low level language of having small program size, that is overhead involved in such program is low. And because it is a lightweight and smaller program, so speed of execution is fast, which is similar to the characteristics of a low level language. So from this we can see that C contains the important features of both high level as well as low level language, and so it is known as middle level language. Brief history of C. C was developed by Dennis Ritchie at Bell Laboratories in USA in 1972. Basically, it was developed for the Unix operating system. Even nowadays, the kernels of various operating systems like Windows, Linux, Mac, and Android are developed with C. And even the popular database languages like Oracle, MySQL, etc. use C language in their development. Now, because the C language program are written in high level language platform, and computer does not understand a program written in a high level language. Now the problem is, how can we run a program written in a high level language on a computer? So for that purpose, we have to first convert these high level languages into machine level language. And we need a special software for that, and that software is known as assembler, compiler, or interpreter. Assembler is basically used to convert assembly language program into machine level language programs. And compiler or interpreter converts a program written into high level language into machine level language. Now first, let us consider the work of a compiler. A program written in a high level language is converted into machine level language by a compiler. And whereas in assembler, the program written in assembly language is converted to machine level language or the object code by the assembler. Normally, assembler converts assembly language program to object code, which then needs to be linked with the help of a linker to convert it to a exe file which can be run on a computer. Interpreter is similar to compiler, but there is a difference. A compiler translates entire high level program into a machine level program all at once, that is all in one go. Whereas interpreter converts the program instruction by instruction. That is, it reads first instruction, converts that instruction into equivalent machine language instruction. This machine level instruction is executed by the CPU. Afterwards, interpreter again reads the next instruction and converts it into the machine level language, and so on. So the basic difference between interpreter and compiler is, compiler converts the entire program into the machine level language program in one go, whereas interpreter does it step by step, that is instruction by instruction, line by line. Now the merits of C programming. सी इज़ जनरल पर्पज़ प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. यू कैन जनरेट गेम्स, बिजनेस सॉफ्टवेयर, यूटिलिटीज़, मैथमेटिकल मॉडल्स, वर्ड प्रोसेसर्स, स्प्रेडशीट्स एंड ऑल काइंड ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर. रादर इन प्रीवियस स्लाइड्स वी हैव सीन दैट इट इज़ यूज इन द डिवेलपमेंट ऑफ विंडोज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इन द डिवेलपमेंट ऑफ कर्नल ऑफ एंड्रॉयड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इन द डिवेलपमेंट ऑफ कर्नल ऑफ iMac ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, and even in the development of many database languages like Oracle and so on. Secondly, C is a structured programming language. It gives more stress to while and for loops in place of go-to statements, which causes errors. That is, go-to statement is basically a jump statement. System independence. C does not require any help from the operating system. It runs independently. So C program can be run on any operating system. So it makes it highly portable. Third is high efficiency, because it has many features of low level language. Hence C program contains minimum amount of overhead. Its program is comparatively lightweight and faster as compared to other high level languages, and its instructions are close to the machine level languages of very small computers or microcomputers. And system programming, we have already discussed it. It is used in the development of kernels of various operating systems. In fact, very first operating system developed through C was Unix operating system.